again to another segment of this tutorial. And in this tutorial, we are going to learn about starting a new or starting our first Django project. And to do that, we quickly open our tutorial, and then we are required to do some basic things. So the first thing to do is to open our console. So we write this cmd in the run command, and then we are to navigate to where our virtual environment is. I'll quickly move to where the Windows tutorial is. So what I'm going to do now is to switch to that folder, Django Girls, which is located on my drive C. And then after it finish changing directory to that, it should just quickly move straight to activating our virtual environment for us. Activate. Okay, nice one. Oh, that is quite fast. All right, so the next thing to do over here is to type in Django. The next thing to do is to type django-admin. I'll quickly zoom this. Okay, so let's type that command, django-admin.py start project my site, and then dot. Don't forget that dot when you are entering this in the console, and hit enter. Alright, we are good to go. Alright, so the next thing to do is to check our directory and see what's there. So dir, you can see we have manage my site, my virtual environment, as you can see over here. When you switch to my site, we should have the breakdown of this. I'll quickly do that by using the GUI for you to see the tree. Okay, so this is my site, and you can see we have the what we are seeing over here as well. I'll quickly minimize this. Alright, so our next thing to do over here is to open the setting.py inside this folder where the Django Girls is. So we come to my site, then settings. Then we are going to edit it with our text editor, which is the Sublime Text. So you right click on this and then open with Sublime Text. I'll quickly put this to the other side as well. Alright, nice one. So the next thing to do is to set up our time zone, and I'm in Africa, and to be precise, we'll be using Accra. So we quickly come down and locate where the time zone is in this particular setting file in time zone. All right, so where the time zone is in by default it is UTC, so we clean this and write Africa / then Accra where you are. And then the next thing to do is, so I'll quickly copy this for the sake of time. So then we locate where the static URL is somewhere at the down, so we clean all these ones and then paste it over there. Nice one. And then the next thing to do is to where allow host is, we put in this particular this. So I'll copy the square brace and go and replace the other one. So you move to the top here. Okay, so come here, then you paste that over there. It's not supposed to be double equal to, just one single equal to. All right, so after you are done with that, is there anything you are going to do? Alright, so we are going to save this. After I successfully save it, then so that is set up a database. So the default everything is there, DB SQLite, so we can quickly do that. Alright, so the next thing to do is to come to the console and then type in this command over there. I'll quickly copy this, then I'll come here and paste. Alright, so all I have to do is to hit enter, then wait patiently for Python manage.py to migrate our files for us, and also create other necessary files or content types for us. Alright, nice one. It's migrating our staffs. Alright, so let's quickly move down, 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 down. Alright, so the next thing to do is to run to start our server by typing python manage.py. So I'll just press this, and instead of migrate, I'll write run server, the web server. So the web server started running over here. So we copy this URL. So when you highlight something in console, just press enter, then it automatically copy that for you. I'll quickly move to this, open this, we come back to that, then paste the URL over there, or the IP that has been generated by the server for us to access our local content in our browser. So I'll hit enter. Welcome, it's worked. Congratulations on your first Django powered page. That is awesome. And then let's quickly move back to our tutorial. So we are seeing this and we are good to go. And now let's press Control C to terminate that. And then it is time to create some content. So let's quickly move to this. Okay, now we are moving to Django models, and we come down, 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 down. And to create our first model, what you are supposed to do is to type in this command, Python. I'm going to bring this in up a little bit. So we type in Python. So I'll not type that. I'll just press the arrow key, the top one. And then type in start app blog, and then hit enter. Wait patiently for the files to be created. Alright, so the files are created now. When we type in dir in the console, we should have blog added as a directory to that particular folder or that particular directory of Django Girls. Alright, so the next thing to do is to add blog to the installed apps by going to the setting, the file that we've opened previously. Then we come to where installed apps are and hit enter, and then single quote, then we write blog and then terminate it. After doing that, then we save it, we save the file. And then we are going to create a blog post model. So we have to come back to where the Django Girls folder is, and then go to blog, this folder, navigate to blog, then where model is, then we right click, and then open with Sublime Text Editor. All right, so you can see we are supposed to do some few tasks over here by transferring the content of this to that particular page. Or that particular file. So I will highlight this and then delete this and paste this over here. For the sake of time, I have to do this. Alright, so make sure you are mindful of the indentation, so you use the tab key to make that happen. And if you don't do this correctly, it will generate error for you. So what you see over here is the same, it should be in line. And then you are good to go. That's one thing about Python. It's much focused on your indentation than any other thing. So if you joke with indentation, it will joke with you as well. Alright. Okay. Alright, so I'll save this file now. And then quickly move down, 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 down. And then I'm sure I didn't save. Okay, so you save now, then you come back to your console and then type this. Instead of startup, you write make migrations blog, then you hit enter. All right, so it has done that for us. Then the next thing to do is to type Python manage.py migrate. So according to the tutorial, we're supposed to then migrate block. So we have to type that. So we come here. Instead of make migration, you see migrate block. Then you hit enter. Then you wait for it to do the miracles. All right, nice. Our block push is now in the model, and we are good to go. All right, so the next thing to do is to work with the Django admin. So we quickly move to the Django admin file in the it's already in the block. So when you look at the path block, then /admin.py, which is over here, block, then admin. Then we right click on this file as well, then open with Sublime Text Editor. Then we copy the content over here, and then we paste it over here, right click. Okay, so that's all that we are supposed to do here. And just give some space over here and save. After saving it, we come to our console. Then you're supposed to run the server again. So enter this, and then we are going to, this time we are not going to use 127.0.0.1. Is to 8000. Instead, we will write this and type, use the forward slash with admin attached to it. So I'll quickly copy this link and then come to this side. Oh, in simple, that particular site is already open, so we just add this to it, admin. Alright, so you know that when you go to Facebook or any social media outlet, you're supposed to sign in and you require username and password before you'll be able to do anything like post your selfies, etc. Similar to website, we have the front end. The front end is what you can see over here. So this is the front end of the website. And when we log in, that is where we call it the back end. We call it back end. So that is where you do your administrative voice, etc. Alright, so let's quickly move to the tutorial and then see what's next for us. Alright, so you know that we've not created any password or anything to be able to have access to this site. So the next thing we have to do is to create a user account, which is super user account, by typing this command inside the console, this. Copy this, then come to console, press Ctrl C to stop that, and then use the left click to automatically paste in the console. That is when you copy the text from anywhere. Then you hit enter. Alright, so it's asking us to create a username, and it says if you want to leave the default or leave blank to use no allow. But I don't prefer that, so I'll use Django Girls Who as my username. That's spelled well, correct. And then our email address. You have to fill all this djangogirls.org so that if you've forgotten your password, can be sent to your email address for recovery. Alright, so that is it. And then the password. You're supposed to type. So in the console, if you're typing password, it's not show for you. So nobody knows the length of your password, and then guess it. Nice. All right, nice one. My super user, I've created an account on the system now. So I'll just run the server now, and then come to where the listing is. Open to that particular URL which has already been opened, and then our username is Django Girls Who, and then the password is only known to me. Then I'll hit enter. Nice one. So we are now at the Django administration dashboard, and you can see view sites, change password, logout, groups, users, posts, etc. Alright, so let's quickly move to the tutorial again. Tutorial. And I can minimize this now. Alright, so we are done with this. And we are already here. So let's quickly move down. All right, so the next thing to do is to deploy our website to Python Anywhere and GitHub. All right, so in order, we've already installed a Git and then we've already created an account with Python Anywhere. So all we have to do now is to go come back to our console here and press Ctrl C to stop the server from running. Then you're supposed to type in this particular line of code, git ignite. Alright, so you see it has written that for us. Then we write all this thing over there. So git config global user dot name. Alright, so when you are creating your GitHub account, you realize that we are supposed to write a username in our previous video how to create GitHub and Python Anywhere account. So refer to that. So the username that you've used over here, that is what you are going to put over here as well. So ours was Atogan, and then hit enter, bring this instead of the email the name, you write email over here, and also write the email that you've used in creating your GitHub account, gmail.com. And then if you are done with that, then hit enter. Alright, so all is cleared now. Alright, so the next thing to do is to create a file and then paste this over here. So I'll copy this, I'll quickly copy this. Then you come to Sublime Text, then press Ctrl N for new documents, then paste this over there, then save. And you're going to save this in the Django Girls directory, so to this particular this name. So you copy this dot git ignore, so you paste this, then you save file. After you are done saving the file, we come down again, then we come to the console and type git status. Okay, then the next thing to do, so you can see the git ignore blog manager.py my site, and then the next command that we are supposed to do is to type in git. I'll quickly bring this in up. Git add then or then full stop. Don't forget the full stop over there. Then you hit enter. Okay, so the next thing is to write git commit -m, then the comment, which is my Django Girls app first commit. Then hit enter. Okay, nice one. Then the next thing to do is to push to go to we will be pushing our course to GitHub now. So what you have to do is to go to our GitHub, so which is located here. I've already signed in to GitHub, so I'll put this to this side. And then the next thing to do is to create or start a new project. So I'll quickly click on start a new project over here. Alright, so start. So there we are supposed to write my first blog, but I will change it to Django Girls blog. And then you don't need to do anything again, just simply click on create repository. So when you are done with all this, just click on create repository. Then this particular this will open for you, where you have the HTTPS or the SSH. So all you have to do is to copy this particular one over here, gently copy, or you could possibly come to the extreme end, then select this, then to copy it for you to the clipboard, any of them that you want to use. Alright, so after we are done with that, we come to our console. So here is the console. I'll bring this in up. Then we write git remote add origin. Then we, you know how to paste by using the left click whenever you copy something. Then you hit enter. Then we say git push this command. push origin master. Wait patiently for it to connect to our Git repository. Sorry, I didn't click on that. Alright, so this should pop up for you to enter your username and password. So I'll type our username, which is this @Atogan, and then the password. Only known to me. Then you hit OK, login. Then Git will try to authenticate that if it really exists or not. Alright, so nice one. Everything has been stored on our branch now. So, the next thing to do is to setting up our blog on Python Anywhere and then pulling our code. So we quickly move to Python Anywhere. Then we type this in the bash. So we go to this. But then we... No, stop it. Okay, so now we just type git clone and then attach this particular URL to that place. So we come to this and... to make this bold first, see, I'll make this enlarge. So we come to the Python Anywhere. Then when you are here, when you are make sure you are logging, then you come to bash. So we wait for the bash to load, and then we are good to go. So the bash is similar to the console, and so it's relating to this in Linux-based operating system. So we write git clone, and then the URL, we paste it over there. Okay, so I'll come back to, okay, so let me quickly copy this, then come to the bash, then we paste this, and then you hit enter. Okay, so they said this is already in this directory. I'll click. Okay, so I'll redo that again over here. And I'll hit enter. Alright, so it's cloning that particular this thing for us. And then the next thing to this chain directory, then to the Django Girls blog. So chain directory Django Girls blog. I'll hit enter. We are there now. So I'll quickly shift this to the left side. The right side, sorry. Come on, why did I just click on that? Alright, so if you are done changing directory to Django Guest Blog, the next thing is to install the virtual environment. So we quickly type that over here. So this is actually a Linux command. You realize that installing the virtual environment in Windows is quite different from what you are going to do over here. So we type in virtual environment -- Python. I'll quickly zoom this so that we can see it clearly. This. So I'll type that over there. Virtual env -- Python equal to Python 3.5. That is 3.5, but initially when we are dealing with our stats, we were using Python 3.6, not Python 3.5. So the latest version is 3.6, so we will not be typing 3.5 for now. We type 3.6. And then my venv. Good, you are good to go now. Then you hit enter. So it will automatically install the virtual environment on our system. Nice one. We have successfully installed a virtual environment. Then the next thing to do is to activate the virtual environment by typing source my VEN NV, then this bin this, then activate. Then we hit enter. And now the next thing to do is to install Django. So we say pip install Django. If you want to specify the version, you can just do that. You could just use pip install Django and to look for the latest version of Django. So when you are done typing this, then all you have to do is to hit enter. Then it automatically download the Django file for us and then proceed to installation. Then after it has finished installing, as we did earlier on Windows, it will tell us successfully installed Django. So let's wait patiently for it to install. Alright, waiting for it to install. Alright, so it has successfully installed the Django version 1.11.5 for us. Then the next thing to do is to type python manage.py migrate. So python manage.py migrate. Come on, migrate. And we hit enter. Wait patiently for it to do all that stuff. Then the next thing to do now is to move to Python Anywhere. We will move from the bash to the Python Anywhere and then locate. We are now going to create the virtual environment. So first go to web. Then we create a new web app. And you click on next. Then it's Django project, so Django. And then you realize we've installed Django 1.11, then that. And the project can be my site, or we can leave it to my site. Then we click on next. Can give it your project name, actually. So I'll just leave it to my site as we wait for it to set up all other stuffs. We have to come back to, we're forgetting one code, which is the Python manage.py, whereby we create the super user account. I can come back to, okay. So let's wait for the web app to finish doing that. I'll launch the console in another tab so that we input that particular code. This one, whereby we create our user account to be able to have access to the site. Alright, so I will quickly come down. And the next thing to do is to configure our virtual environment. So we come to the web, then we come down, and then locate the path. So this is it. So we say home and slash the name of the account, Atogan. Or the username, then slash Django Girls. The listing is Django Girls. Django Girls blog slash then my VENV. After you're done, you just select this that you are done with the path of your virtual environment. So we will do this. Alright, so I'll pause the video over here and continue in the next video. Alright, bye.